This hand's not the best, not the worst. I'm gonna keep it though. We got enough action going on. Probably just gonna turn one Birds of Paradise plus Skull Clamp. Watch him kill the birds somehow. And brainstorm into a land to play Survival. Graphic's Cage, yeah, that's fine. Naturally. This is good. I get to show you guys how to beat a Gravedigger's Cage with this deck. It takes a little bit of finicking, but it's not actually that hard. That's not to say the Gravedigger's Cage isn't good against me, just it's not like a death knell or anything. Basically, we're just going to chain some Basking Root Walls together. And then Skull Clamp them. And then just play some Fair Magic after we draw a pile of cards. Fair Magic. Put that in air quotes. Obviously, it would have been more ideal to have the misstep for the always firing. Yeah, that's fine. Oh man. Everything I predicted when I kept this opener is coming true. Must be some kind of profit. Only expected to go brainstorm Naked Survival here, but I drew a land, so I'm gonna go. Just gonna cast a Survival. With mana up. Yeah, so even though he has a Gravedigger's Cage in play, he still has to force the Survival. Which shows you just like how effective Gravedigger's Cage actually is at stopping Survival, which it's not. Like Gravedigger's Cage against Oath of Druid, so like Gravedigger's Cage, nice Oath of Druid that doesn't do anything. And then they have all these Forbidden Orchards in their deck and stuff. Your Gravedigger's Cage against me, you still have to force the Survival. And then instead of having like Orchards in my deck like that actively hinder me, I've got like a Venge Bond to attack and kill Jace and stuff. I'm gonna probably gonna brainstorm on his turn anyway, but I'm gonna wait for him to Demonic Tutor. I'm not gonna force the Demonic Tutor if I draw a Force of Will, so might as well wait. He could go like Mox Jet, Thoughtseize you, which would change how the brainstorm went. I'd like to brainstorm here, because if I hit a land, then I'll be able to cast the Venge Mind on my turn. And I do hit a land. So it's nice. The main point of Dream Mage is to find Skull Clamp. So since I already have a clamp, I'm going to shuffle away the Dream Mage. Put back like so. So we're going to have not a bad clock here. The first Venge Mind hit is going to put him down to 13. And then next turn, we can cast this Root Wall if we really want to. We're probably going to play the Root Wall and then clamp it immediately, I imagine. But we could also hold it to clock him, because it would take a turn off his life total that way. But just clamping the Root Wall is probably going to find us gas to do something similar. If our attack next turn would put him down to 13, then it would make more sense to play the Root Wall, because then it's a two-turn clock. Yeah, that's not happening. I'm gonna put this on my list of cards that aren't resolving. It was only one card. Nile Spellbomb, okay. Oh. Well, how about that? Well, that seems better than clamping for now. Fire this bad boy off. We want to recall before we do anything else, because if we hit land plus Vengevine, we want to be able to cast it. And he's fetching in response. I think he's going to crack the Nile Spellbomb, draw a card, and see if he draws a misstep. He didn't draw a misstep. And hey, look, we drew a Mana Source and Vengevine. So we could go Guy Guy Clamp Clamp and draw four more cards this turn. But he's only got two cards in hand. He's going to go up to three. We don't have to worry about him Yogg's Willing for the win or anything like that, because he's got a Gravedigger's Cage in play for us. I think it's better to just eight him. Just eight him down to four. So that's what I'm going to do. And then if he handles my board presence, I'll just clamp some stuff next turn. So the Jet taps for black. I think I get another drop here. Rawr. So that's the thing about like Gravedigger's Cage and Niles Bohem. It's still, I think I showed him Snapcaster Mage last game. So like he doesn't know how many Snapcasters are in my deck. He doesn't know that there's just the one. So it could make sense to just have the Cage Nail Spell Bomb. Especially if those are the only two cards. Though they haven't been really ideal this game. Oh, he's looting. He should just steal my Skull Clamp for the max troll. It's my clamp now. But he probably has some like legitimate outs, like Lotus into Time Walk, for example. Gives me the GG. Cool, that's classy. And there's the pack.